Call this meeting to order at 7:39 PM. Roll call.
President Mordis.
Present.
Vice President Rose.
Present.
Parliamentarian Yankton. Here. Executive Secretary Layton. Absent. Senator Barkley. Absent. Student Trustee Universe. Absent. Senator Archipong. Absent. Senator Allen. Absent. Senator Corgan. Senator DeLaFlippo.
Present.
Senator Dubasson. Absent. Senator Garland.
Present.
Senator Gates.
Present.
Senator Lecce.
Present.
Senator Lomini.
Present.
Senator McDonald.
Present.
Senator Quaid.
Present.
Senator Ryder.
Present.
Senator Ridicus.
Yeah, Ridicus. Present.
Senator Smokia.
Present.
Senator Venter.
Present.
Senator Yazzie.
Present.
12 voting senators.
We move to approve the agenda for November 1st, 2022. Is there a motion to approve the agenda? Motion made by Senator Samakia. Is there a second? Seconded by Senator Venter. Anything for debate and discussion? Senator Gates?
I am going to motion to add the All University Committee to committee reports, as well as Residence Hall Association to committee reports as well.
Okay. A motion has been made to add All University Committee and Residence Hall Association committee reports to committee reports. Is there a second? Seconded by Senator Lecce. Anything for debate and discussion? Seeing none, we move to vote. All those in favor? Opposed? Abstaining? Motion passes 11-0-1. 13 as the fly right now, voting members. So the motion passes 12-0-1. Next, is there anything else for debate and discussion about passing the agenda of November 1st, 2022? Seeing that we move to vote, all those in favor? Opposed? Abstaining? Motion passes 13-0-0. Next, we move to approve the minutes of the meeting for October 25th, 2022. Is there a motion to approve? Motion made by Senator Yazzie. Is there a second? Seconded made by Senator DeFilippo. Is there anything for debate and discussion? Seeing none, we move to vote. All those in favor? Opposed? Abstaining? Motion passes 13-0-0. Next, we move to the appointment of the new executive board member. Move to appoint Jeremy Yazzie as treasurer, submitted by Aiden Mortis, president. Before we motion, because this is a movement, I'm going to have Senator Yazzie come up and talk about it, a little bit about why he wants to be treasurer, and then you all have questions. You can all ask him questions. So Senator Yazzie, I'm going to have you take a step in the middle right there.
So I want to be treasurer so I can help out the finance section of SGA. I want to make sure that everyone's aware of their student fee too, just because I feel like some people aren't always aware that they pay. And so I also want to make sure that the organizations are the correct ones, that we include everyone, that the events that they put on. And I also want to grow as myself too, as a person, and become more of a leader.
All right, are there any questions for Senator Yazzie? Senator Gates.
I do have two questions for you. What other things are you involved in on campus?
I am an RA in Scott Hall. And I am also a DJ in WBIM.
Okay. How do you plan to manage your time with the other positions that you hold?
Well, like I always do with everything, I have a schedule color-coded on my desk that's pinpointed on it, so I have everything down, and then that's for like the things that are reoccurring, and then extra things that I have right down on my whiteboard, so I keep notes there as well to make sure I keep everything in track, and that usually pretty goes well.
Any other questions for Senator Yazzie? Senator DeFilippo.
How do you plan on achieving your goals if you become treasurer?
Well, I know it's going to be a little tough at first, but that's why we have Matt Miller, who I hope will help, and we can grow together. And, you know, I just want to work hard and put my time and effort into it like I was as a senator, and I'm very determined, and I know I'll get the job done.
All right. Any other questions for Senator Yazzie? All right. Seeing none, just as the FYI, this does require a two-thirds vote by the Senate in order for Senator Yazzie to be appointed as treasurer. So I'll start with the motion. Is there a motion to approve Senator Yazzie as treasurer? Motion made by Senator Lecce. Is there a second? Seconded made by Senator Venter. Is there anything else for the debate and discussion? Seeing none, we move to vote. All those in favor? Opposed? Abstaining? Motion passes 10-1-1. Correct. Yeah. All right, so congratulations, Senator Yossi. With that being said, we move into the swearing of the new members submitted by Aiden Morris, the president. So, thank you, Vice President Rose.
Gotcha.
I love this long little walk.
We need like a little open section for the tables.
We really should have one next year. All right, so Senator Yossi, same thing as you did for President Yossi now. Yeah, perfect. Raise your right hand. You get in there. Same thing you did when you were appointed as senator. You're going to repeat after me. So, I state your name in full.
I, Jeremy Yossi.
Do hereby affirm.
Do hereby affirm.
To uphold the Constitution.
To uphold the Constitution.
And bylaws.
And bylaws.
Of the student government.
Of the student government.
Association.
Association.
To protect the right.
To protect the right.
Of the students.
Of the students.
To pursue both.
To pursue both.
Academic freedom.
Academic freedom.
In an active role.
In an active role.
In cooperative.
In cooperative.
College governance.
College governance.
As a member.
As a member.
Of the student governing.
Of the student governing.
Body.
Body.
It is my duty.
It is my duty.
To give thoughtful.
To give thoughtful.
And unselfish.
And unselfish.
Consideration.
Consideration.
To the students.
To the students.
Concerns.
Concerns.
And take responsible actions.
Take responsible actions.
In fulfilling.
In fulfilling.
The students' interests.
The students' interests.
Congratulations.
Motion to add Treasurer Yossi to the role.
I am not going to hear that motion. There's a reason why. Senator McDonald.
Senator, to recall the role?
Yes. Is there a second to recall the role? Seconded by Senator Lecce. Is there anything for debate and discussion? Seeing none, we move to vote. All those in favor? Opposed? Abstaining? Motion passes unanimously. Treasurer Yossi, now you can come take your seat over here.
President Mortis.
Present.
Vice President Rose.
Present.
Treasurer Yossi.
Present.
Parliamentary Yankton. Here. Executive Secretary Layton. Absent. Senate Chair Barkley. Absent. Student Trustee Universe. Absent. Senator Archipov. Absent. Senator Allen. Absent. Senator Corgan.
Present.
Senator De La Flippo.
Present.
Senator Dubuisson, absent. Senator Garland?
Present.
Senator Gates?
Present.
Senator Lecce?
Present.
Senator Lomani?
Present.
Senator McDonald?
Present.
Senator Quay?
Present.
Senator Ryder?
Present.
Senator Ridikas?
Present.
Senator Smakia?
Present.
Senator Benter?
Present.
12 voting senators.
Thank you. All right, we now move on to executive reports. President. Hello, everyone. I hope you all are having a great week and a great Tuesday. I first want to say that November is Indigenous Peoples Month, so with that being said, I just want to remind everyone that I respectfully acknowledge that Bridgewater, Mass. Sits on the land of the Wampanoag Nation, whose histories and hardships have not always been told. With that being said, I want to thank everyone who came to the NCHE Student Forum yesterday. It really helped. Your positives and negatives about the school both helped to improve the experience of Bridgewater State as we move through the accreditation process. So yeah, the final part of the NCHE kind of visit is going to be an open campus review tomorrow at 10 a.m. in the Heritage Room in the library. If you would like to go, you are more than welcome to. It is an open event. It will go from about 10 to 11:15. I also want to announce that Senator Griffin did resign. She resigned due to SGA kind of not being in her cards and instead focusing on a new pathway. We wish her the best as she goes towards this new pathway. I do want to congratulate Treasurer Yossi for his appointment tonight to Treasurer. We are very excited to see all the amazing things you are going to do. At some point within the next week, I'm going to be reaching out to Charlotte Lewis, who is in charge of the Pink Locker, very similar to the Purpose Locker that VP Rose has talked about. And seeing if we can set a meeting, kind of talk about what her ideas are for help on campus. And finally, next Tuesday, November 8th, is Election Day. It is a midterm year. We are in 2022, which is a midterm year. If you have not voted yet, I highly, highly, highly recommend you go and do that. It is your civic duty as United States citizens to go and cast your vote on who you want to represent yourself in the Senate as well as in the Congress. We have a lot of important races this year. Our governor's up first, our governor's seat is up, as well as a couple of questions on the ballot. If you want more information, President Clark did send out an email earlier today about voting next week, so please make sure to read that if you need more information. With that being said, end report, Vice President.
Hi, friends. Sorry, I'm so used to hearing Anique's voice. Not registered. Hope everybody's doing well. It's really good to see all your faces here. I know it might have, you know, the last few weeks, especially with midterms, been a little crazy. So I'm really happy to see that everybody's here and, you know, doing well. Safety assessment tour is tomorrow. 5 to 7. The shifts have been posted today. I know there was a little bit of a mix-up this morning, and honestly, I think it was just a little tiny glitch of what was going on. I did check in with senators to make sure that they could see it after I kind of mingled with it, and they should be up now. So if you're not seeing it on your end and you're interested in getting involved, let me know. Just come up to me directly after the meeting, and we can touch base with that. So we're going to be meeting in RSU. What that will look like is just a briefing on what will happen. There will be a division of teams, two teams, one side for the west side, one side for the east side. There was logistics looked into, and there is a path that will be taken for those teams. So if you have any questions about that and something that you would be looking at on this tour is just accessibility services of, is this accessible for wheelchairs and people with disabilities? I think that's primarily one of the great things to look at, and then safety. So have you noticed that people are speeding on the streets? Or, you know, is there, you know, certain things that you really like to look at and haven't noticed before, such as the blue lights or anything like that? If you have noticed something on campus, let us know. And at the end, there will be a briefing of what we looked at, so a debriefing. And like I said, if you have any questions, please see me after the meeting. Secondly, the National Guard and Military and Veterans Office is hosting an event on the 5th. I'm talking about this today because it is a primary advocacy issue. So there is 150 around veterans here on campus, and it is extraordinarily low. Some of them don't even know that they do have an office. So I think it's really important that we look into that and have more promotion around that and get more people, you know, involved. So what that event will look like is a military obstacle course and then pushing a Humvee. So that's very exciting. And if you have any questions about that, please let me know again after the meeting. Great, end of report.
Treasurer, you have a report. Treasurer, I'll see if I understand a report.
No report.
All right, parliamentarian.
Hi. Yesterday, policy board voted on a minor edit of the bylaws, which was just changing the 450 to the 3,001 cents, just due to the fact that the minor edit was missed during last year's bylaw edits, as these edits were voted on during the 21-22 SGA session. If you're interested in the minor bylaw change, it's under Article VIII, budget process, under Section 2, SGA funding request system, Article E. End of report.
Executive Secretary is not here. They have no report. Next is Student Trustee. Student Trustee Universe attended a couple of NECHI events. That attended with myself on Sunday night, the NECHI Welcome Dinner, and had a really good time meeting with some of the NECHI people then. In addition, Student Trustee Universe attended the Trustee Forum yesterday and had a lot of fun in addition, talking about certain trustee things that were happening. Finally, the next Board of Trustee meeting will be December 13th or 14th. It's the day before the last day of classes. We unfortunately won't be able to send senators due to us having a Senate meeting. However, we will send a report to board letting them know. Next thing we need to Senate Chair, Senator Barkley, just wanted me to remind you all that your agenda item submission should be in by Friday at noon. Anything after Friday at noon for now won't be considered late and will not be put on the agenda. The goal is for Senator Chair Barkley to start sending out the agenda a little bit earlier than she has been, so please get your agenda items in by Friday at noon at the latest. Next thing we move to board reports, executive board. Hello again, everyone. Today, executive board, we kind of just talked about what every board was kind of doing initiative wise. We talked a little bit about what advocacy was doing with the purpose locker and some other initiatives. In addition, what policy board was doing with the little bylaw changes. End report, advocacy board.
Hi, friends. Once again, hope we're all doing well. Just an update on advocacy board. We did end up canceling advocacy board, but in replacement of that, we did end up going to a NECHI event, which was from 4:30, lasted for an hour and a half. If you don't know what NECHI is, they're actually all volunteer, either provosts or deans or members of admin of different colleges from the area. So there was Maine and Connecticut. I don't know, I just thought it's so cool that people volunteer to kind of look at other colleges and do that. So that was very interesting to me. And there was a lot of involvement from the Senators of Advocacy Board. So I really just like to send my thank you for being such great participants. And especially Senator Ryder, just wanted to comment on how you expressed your thank you during that meeting. So things are noticed and I just wanted to express that you did a great job. Other than that, I did attend another NECHI meeting today at 11:30. More pizza was there, which is great. I love pizza. something to mention, too, is that there was a lot of grad students, more grad students than there were at the last NECHI meeting, so I think it was extraordinarily successful. So, you know, I think that was great. That is all I have for advocacy board. End of report.
Finance board.
Senator Corrigan will be giving the finance board report.
Finance board met on Thursday. We reviewed and approved the African American Society's request for $250 for a family feud event they are hosting on November 29th. We also reviewed finance board section of the SGA Constitution bylaws. End of report.
Thank you. Policy board.
Policy board report will be given by Senator Garland.
Hello. On Monday, policy board reviewed the SGA bylaws edits that parliamentarian Yankton will be working on. Yankton should be finishing editing by next week. By next week's policy board meeting, as we will review them before bringing them to the SGA Senate meeting. We received the BSU Chemistry Club Constitution yesterday. We'll be reviewing the Constitution on Monday. End of report.
Thank you. Public Relations Board did not meet last week because it was a Friday Classical Journal Wednesday. They will, however, be meeting tomorrow at 8 p.m. in the SGA office. They'll be working on some of the templates they had started to do last time they met, as well as other posts to go up on our Instagram and other social medias. And Elections Board has no report. Next, we move to committee reports. Our University Committee submitted by Ashley Gates, Senator Barge.
I would love to have you all guess to see how long All University Committee lasted, but because we are in Robert's Rules, it lasted around 15 minutes, which I think is one of the quickest ones that we've had in a very long time. But we approved the academic calendars up until 2027, which is pretty fun. It seems so close yet so far. And then we also approved the UMass Law joint degree program to change it in our end to reflect that 3.3 GPA that is needed. I know somebody asked last week why we were changing it to a 3.3. I did ask that during AUC, and the answer I got was that UMass Dartmouth had always had that reflected in their on their end. We just were changing it on our end to reflect what they kind of always had. End of report.
Thank you. Next, we move to Residence Hall Association report given by Tyler Corrigan, resident at large.
Hello. So Dining came last week and they talked about how robots will be coming to Crimson starting this week. There's also $12,000 left in their budget, so if you are a resident and you want to advocate for new things or whatever, come to RHA and submit a form to possibly get that approved. And for Bristol Cup, this last week it was Halloween Trivia Kahoot. Miles Bernardo got first place, Durgan got second place, and Woodward finally got third place. End of report.
All right, is there anything else for committee reports? Seeing none, we move to old business. Is there anything else for old business? Seeing none, we move to new business. Announcement of recognition winners for September and October, submitted by Aiden Morris, president. So, as you know, thank you. We have a lot of recognition stuff to give out for the past 2 months that we've been here in classes. We're gonna start their student leaders of the month. They unfortunately both cannot be here with us. However, they'll be recognized a little bit later on. It's just a reminder about what student leader of the month gets. They get this lovely plaque. I'm blocking out the name for now. They also have a dinner with myself and Joel and two friends of their choosing, and a date that we can all kind of come together. So yeah, so our first leader of the month came from September. This student was a SOC this past summer and was one of the driving forces behind the creating of the new orientation experience known as the Crimson Experience. In addition, this individual has done an incredible job being involved within CSC with Engage being SU and being an MC along with yours truly for the homecoming pageant. I'd like to say congratulations to Ashley Rosenthal for winning. Ashley has been contacted. She does know she won the award. But yep, so this is going to Ashley when we see her. And our next winner is a student whose contribution was really big this month and one of the biggest events on campus for this past month called Beware the Bear. They were a driving force behind this inaugural event. Their contribution included working with the scare actors, the tour guides, and operations for the event along with the makeup artist. Overall, without the student support, this event could not have gone out without a hitch. So that being said, I would like to congratulate our October winner for Student Leader of the Month, Kyle Imbo. So our lovely two winners have been notified and they will come and get their prize and the photo op at a time that we can all agree on, as well as the dinner with Dr. O. Our final award we're giving out tonight is our Senator of the Month award. So this month we focused on the Senator of the Month, focusing on the theme of the CSC bravery. So someone who steps out of their comfort zone, someone who goes away from the grain, et cetera, et cetera. So the executive board sat and decided, we decided that the senator who deserved it this month was someone who really stepped out of their comfort zone throughout the first 2 months of the semester. This senator took on a position they really didn't have to take on, but did it because they love SGA that much and was really brave of them. They dealt a lot this last 2 months, learning some new ins and outs of Engage and everything like that. So that being said, I'd like to congratulate our October Senator of the Month, Mr. Jacob Quay.
So for this month, the executive board, it goes to the executive board member who exemplifies bravery. And for this month, the Senate had decided that Vice President Rose should exemplify bravery.
Go Bears! 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 All right, before we move on, I just want to announce that our November CSC Terror of the Month is going to be respect. So we're looking for people who are very respectful this month, so respectful to yourself, to your fellow senators, to property and office, et cetera, et cetera. So be on the lookout for an e-board member senators, and an e-board be on the lookout for senators who exemplify respect this month. All right, with that being said, is there anything else for new business? Seeing none, we move to open forum. Is there anything for open forum? Seeing none, we move to announcements. So we'll start with Senator DeFilippo. Go around, we'll go to the gallery, and then they'll end with me. So Senator DeFilippo.
Well, this is the first I start. First of all, congratulations to Senator Kwa and Vice President Rose for their accolades and achievements that they have received and will probably continue to receive throughout the SGA period. Normally, I have a spiel about Roche Brothers, but I'm not working this weekend because I have to go home for a wake. So I just want to take the time to for you all to kind of understand that, you know, things happen very suddenly, and you don't know what is going to happen in the next immediate moment. So please tell your friends, tell your family, tell all your loved ones that you care about, even people that, you know, you might not like. You know, everyone is kind of a human being, so please, you know, tell them that you care about them, that you're always there for them, because you don't know what will happen. So I didn't get that chance, so I hope that you all kind of do. So I know it's kind of bringing the mood down, but the Roach Pro schedule will come back next week. But that's my announcement.
No announcements.
Congratulations to these two Senate of the Month. I'm very proud of them. That pizza was great. It was fantastic. They deserve it because they are well-prepared and diligent senators. I respect all that, and a report.
The next coming week, leading up to the election, I encourage you all to look around the polling stations and be grateful for what I guess the Commonwealth has provided for us. A lot of other polling stations around the country are not as lucky. End of announcement.
No announcement.
Hi, friends. Hope we're all doing well. First of all, I'd like to thank you all for you know, voting for me. I really appreciate that and for this outstanding award. I mean, I love this organization, and I care about what BSU's growth looks like in the future, but more so importantly, I care about your growth as a leader. So I'm just really excited that, you know, you guys noticed that, and I appreciate you all. Secondly, if you don't know, I am a ROTC Army cadet, which is great. There are some really exciting things happening this week. Sunday, we went to the range, which is so much fun. Worked with M4s and did a lot of cleaning, which is great. Love that. And we have an 8-mile ruck coming up. If you don't know what a ruck is, or 8-mile ruck, it's kind of an event, you know, as well as an item. It's a bag that you fit a lot of weight into. The minimum is 35 pounds, and you would walk the certain distance. It's either 4, 6, 8, or 12, which is so much fun. So the final to qualify and pass ROTC is a 12-mile. It's the same for basic. But that is kind of what we're preparing for with an 8-mile ruck. If you're interested in learning about that and getting a good exercise and participating, let me know, which is great. And if I'm missing anything, obviously some of my ROTC friends can, you know, fill in the blanks for that one. Awesome. End of announcements.
Hi. Like I said, ICAA is hosting a wide range of events in November. We have the BSU Powwow, which is on November 20th. It's marking 12 years that we've been hosting this powwow here. Very exciting, came back from the pandemic. As well, there's so many events I do not know on the top of my head. It's we're currently trying to figure out our schedule as there's different student organizations as well as departments reaching out to us to collab on a lot of events, so we're figuring out our schedule. Last announcement is policy board, please come find me after Senate and announcements.
Hi everyone.
Hi Jerome.
I just want to thank you all for this opportunity. I really appreciate it to be able to sit with these lovely people, and I thank you for the opportunity. So, any announcements?
Hello, fellow creatures of the night, or not, if you have a better sleep schedule than me. I'm really looking forward to figuring out what the Senate of the Month criteria is for December, because I sure know I'm not winning this month. End of announcement.
No announcements.
Hi, everyone. I just want to congratulate Vice President Rose for winning Executive Board Position of the Month. I think you were in that position through your position as Vice President and in your role in Advocacy Board. I want to congratulate you for winning the award this month. I also want to congratulate Senator Kwa for winning Senator of the Month for rising up to the challenge this month and being an example to what the many examples for the Senate. Also, next week is Election Day. Every congressional representative is up for re-election, and also we got a new governor. A new governor will be taking over next year. And end of announcements.
Hi everyone. So first of all, I just want to congratulate Vice President Rose, and also thank you, E-Board, for voting me Senator of the Month. Jeremy, good luck. There's a Matt Miller out in the crowd. He's worked some magic, so if you ever need, he's up in 103. So that's fun. Also, now Halloween's gone, so it's Christmas. So Merry Christmas. Happy New Year.
Happy Hanukkah.
That's all I have.
Hello, everyone. First, I have an update for policy board. I do not currently have my Connect card on me, so go team. For those of you who don't know, I've had to get a new Connect card too many times this semester. Got that $100 new Connect card fee on my e-bill right now because it's really getting up there. Should probably keep track of it more often. I also know that I started last week doing something called Roses. If you weren't here last week, I'm kind of just giving my appreciation through the form of roses to people this week. So the first roses are for Aiden Mortis because he's Aiden Mortis and he lets me call him Aiden Mortis and he drives me around everywhere. So go to. My second roses goes to Senator Venter because she's an amazing writer for the Comment and puts up with me in my constant emailing this weekend, being like, hey, I don't know what to do. Roses to Vice President Rose for putting up to me singing The Climb a few weeks back in the car, because I do that sometimes, as well as other things that you put up with for me. So I appreciate you. And then also, last roses go to Jacob Kwa for walking to Mary Lou's with me at like a solid 8 o'clock at night because I decided I needed caffeine, as I do. And the announcements.
No new announcements.
I would like to congratulate Jacob and Vice President Rose. Good job on that. And also, thank you for becoming the treasurer. Now I have a boss. And announcements.
Gary.
I'll say I want to congratulate my best friend Jeremy. He's done really good work here since he came to this campus. And I'm really proud of him. He's done some really good things in a short time. And he's really excited and he's going to do good work. So.
We love you, Jeremy.
Keep doing great things. That's my head RA right there.
That's right. I did have something. So
For me, I just wanted to remind folks that we do have another Speak Your Peace session that's going to happen on November 17th due to how the holidays and breaks have come in or movement of things. We have a little bit more of a intercession from session to session, but just wanted to remind y'all that that is going to happen, and I'll remind you again as we get closer. Date and location, I'll remind you at that point, but for right now, it's Heritage Room at 4 p.m. Additionally, I mentioned this before, but we are having a first-gen proud celebration next week, so be proud, get ready. We'll be having that in the RSU 103, where Matt is also, that was said before. Feel free to stop by. It's a drop-in from 2 to 5. Snacks and other first-gen individuals, both faculty, staff, and students will be there. Come in and grab a couple of goodies and celebrate being first-gen proud. So just wanted to put that out there for folks. If you have any questions, let me know. Thank you.
Matt, did you have anything? You sure?
Yep.
Yes. Christine?
Just congratulations on being able to start several of these award opportunities for folks, and look forward to seeing who else gets them as you continue on recognizing students and yourselves. So congratulations.
Congratulations as well. And I want to thank you all that had the opportunity of showing up and participating in yesterday's student forum and lunch. The reviewers, not surprised at all from my perspective, but were very impressed. And they also indicated that they don't typically see as many students come out for the student forum. So I know we always are looking for more and more, but you all, you know, since the beginning of the semester, knew how important this was. And the most important thing is that you show up. You show up, you do the work, you represent, and there's always good things and then opportunities for improvement. And that's what we always can do better. So if you're able to show up tomorrow at 10 o'clock, that would be wonderful. If not, that's okay, because there's going to be reports that will eventually come out that we'll be able to review with you all in the spring semester. But again, just understanding that how we have arrived to today and yesterday, today and tomorrow was a 2-year process to be able to do a self-study in that document that some of you might have read. But to be able to arrive to that was SGA individuals prior to you, you're currently, and now you're able to lay the groundwork for future students coming to Bridgewater State University. So thank you very much and great job.
Go Bears!
Go Bears!
I don't know how many times I've been to go. We'll do two or three. Everyone, just a reminder to please vote next week. Very important election, as I said earlier, midterms. Midterms tend to have a lower voting rate than general, like 20, like general elections, presidential elections. So let's prove that there could be a high percentage of young voters out there, because we are the generation that's gonna change the world. So please go ahead and vote. Senator Quay, I wanna thank you for your work on this finance chair this semester. You have killed it, and it does not go unnoticed. Once again, congratulations as well for your award. It's well deserved. Treasurer Yassi, once again, congratulations on your appointment as treasurer. And VP Rose, congrats as well for winning Executive Board Member of the Month. You all deserved all the awards you got, so keep up the good work, and I cannot wait to see where the rest of this academic year goes. With a couple of appointments and stuff like that, the boards may change a little bit, so just keep an eye on your email. Nothing too crazy, but just a little bit. There's going to be a CSC birthday bash on November 16th from 1 to 3 in CSC 103. So if you have a November birthday, stop by. There's going to be cake, prizes, and something else that Michaela said in the chat. So don't forget the last one. And a fun fact about Executive Board Member Vice President Rose, that they think scary movies are funny. They laugh at scary movies. With that, I adjourn this meeting at 8:18 p.m.